हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल एस्कर स्कूल ऑफ एक्सलेंस। लास्ट वी लर्न अबाउट द प्लमर विंसन सिंड्रोम। इफ़ यू हैव नॉट सीन येट, गो टू द लिंक गिवन इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बिलो। एंड टुडे वी लर्न अबाउट अ न्यू सिंड्रोम। एंड इफ़ यू हैव नॉट सब्सक्राइब, प्लीज गो एंड सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल फॉर मोर नॉलेजेबल वीडियोज। सो टुडे वी लर्न अबाउट शॉजन सिंड्रोम। You have heard about this, but today we're going to learn forever. So first of all, what is Sjögren's syndrome? Sjögren's syndrome is an autoimmune disease. You know the autoimmune diseases? These are the diseases in which body make antibodies against their own cells. And in Sjögren's syndrome, what happens is there is progressive destruction of salivary and lacrimal glands, leading to keratoconjunctivitis sicca, that is dry eyes, which you can see in the left image, and xerostomia, that is dry mouth, which you can see on the right image. Now comes the type of Sjögren's syndrome. One is primary and second one is secondary. In primary Sjögren's syndrome, there is severe dry mouth, severe dry eyes, widespread dysfunction of exocrine glands, and the incidence of developing lymphomas is high, and there is no association of connective tissue disorders. Always remember that in primary Sjögren's syndrome there is no association of connective tissue disorders. Now comes secondary Sjögren's syndrome. The same is dry mouth and dry eyes, but in secondary Sjögren's syndrome it is associated with connective tissue disorders like primary biliary cirrhosis, which is found nearly in 100% cases with Sjögren's syndrome. Second one is SLE, that is systemic lupus erythematosus, that is associated in 30% cases. And third one is RA, that is rheumatoid arthritis, in cases of 15%. And secondary Sjögren's syndrome female to male ratio is 10:1. Clinical features we already discussed. Now, it is common in middle-aged females who present with dry eyes, dry mouth, enlarged parotids and enlarged lacrimal glands. Often they are tender, means the parotid and lacrimal glands are tender. And superadded infections of the mouth like Candida albicans common. So, after completing types and clinical features, we comes to the investigations. So first one is autoantibody estimation, that is rheumatoid factor, antinuclear factor and salivary duct antibody, which will come positive in case of secondary Sjögren's syndrome. Second one is xylography. Third is estimation of salivary flow, that how much saliva is formed. And fourth one is slit lamp test of eyes. Fifth is Schirmer test to detect the lack of lacrimal secretion. Sixth one is FNAC of parotids and lacrimal glands. And seventh one is 99 technetium pertechnate scan for gland function. Now what is the treatment? Treatment, it is conservative. First one is artificial tears as the patient has dry eyes. Second one is to provide artificial saliva. Third one is to advise frequent drinking of water. And fourth one is treat the cause which is behind Sjögren's syndrome. I hope that this video will be helpful for you. If it is helpful, please like and subscribe my channel for more clinical knowledgeable videos. Thank you so much.